Hello, my friends. Namo Amida Bu. In Buddhism, we speak about the eight consciousness, which are generated when our senses encounter their objects. These eight consciousness are as follows. 1. Consciousness of sight. 2. Consciousness of hearing. 3. Consciousness of smell. 4. Consciousness of taste. 5. Consciousness of touch. 6. Consciousness of mind. 7. Impure mind consciousness. And 8. The alaya or storehouse consciousness. The meaning of the first five consciousness. The meaning of the first five consciousness is easy to comprehend, so I will not dwell upon them. Six, the consciousness of mind integrates the perception of the five senses in concrete images and takes decisions concerning the exterior world. 7. The impure mind consciousness is the source of clinging, and so the origin of the sense of ego, as well as of the other illusions which are born from the fact that the man takes as real something which is merely apparent. The alaya consciousness, or storehouse consciousness, is the place where all the actions and experiences in this life and the previous lives generated by the seven consciousnesses are stored as karma, being the only consciousness which comes along with every birth. This consciousness influences at the same time the workings of the other seven consciousnesses. We take this alaya consciousness with us in all our births, in the various realms of existence. It contains the seeds of various types of karma, and it is the storehouse of the habitual evil karmic tendencies that we have cultivated for eons. Because of the karmic seeds contained in the alaya consciousness, one may die a premature death, be stricken with unexpected disease or inexplicable misfortune. He can be overcome by strong desires, aversions, and obsessions. He can think and do things that one should never even imagine, and so on. So strong is the influence of this alaya consciousness. When Shinran is recorded as saying in chapter 13 of Tanisho, quote, a person may not wish to harm anyone and yet end up killing 100,000 or 1,000 people, end of quote, he is in fact referring to the influence of past karma contained in the alaya consciousness. Here are two questions and answers related with alaya consciousness. Question 1. How can the influence of this alaya consciousness be annihilated in our case as ordinary people? The answer is simple. Only through the Nembutsu of faith in Amida Buddha, we can annihilate the influence of our alaya consciousness. Second question. What exactly happens with alaya consciousness after we receive faith in Amida Buddha? Answer. After we take refuge in Amida Buddha and receive Shinjin, the alaya consciousness or the storehouse consciousness, as well as the other consciousnesses, continue to exist as long as we are still in our samsaric bodies. But at the end of our lives, when we are born in Amida's pure land or his sphere of influence, it naturally melts and is absorbed in the Buddha nature. So, again, the alaya consciousness, as well as the other consciousnesses, continue to exist as long as we are still in our samsaric bodies. But at the end of our lives, when we are born in Amida's Pure Land, these consciousnesses and the alaya consciousness naturally melts and is absorbed in the Buddha nature. It is as the comparison with ice and fire. Once the ice meets fire, or birth in the Pure Land, it becomes water, or Buddhahood. Thus, we can no longer speak about alaya, or storehouse consciousness, after we become Buddhas in the Pure Land. It simply doesn't exist anymore. We can't purify this consciousness, this alaya consciousness, during our lives. But due to Amida's influence, this alaya consciousness becomes powerless and cannot accompany us in the next life. When we receive faith, when we entrust ourselves to Amida Buddha during this present life, the seeds of our karma contained in alaya consciousness are sterilized, never to grow again in a new samsaric plant. It is like the struggle of the fish after it was taken out of the water. It will still move for a while, but it will surely die in short time. Or it is like a cut flower which is put into a vase. It still preserves its color, but will soon wither away. Our karma stored in alaya consciousness is like this. It may continue to influence the present life, but cannot accompany us into the next life, because after we die, we become Buddhas in the moment we are born in the Pure Land. No other religious practice, no other religious practices outside or inside Buddhism can destroy the karmic seeds of the alaya consciousness so easy as the Jodo Shinshu method. This is because in Jodo Shinshu, we become totally connected to the enlightened karmic energy of Amida Buddha, who takes care of everything related with our attainment of Buddhahood. Namo Amida Buddha. Namo Amida Buddha.